Hi guys, and welcome to another Bootstrap 4 video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, this is where we ended up with our last video. We started our little slider here and we've got a little button, some titles. So far we've been doing animations with a bit of custom CSS. If I reload the page, we had this logo that sort of bounces in and stuff like that. Let's continue with that theme and let's animate our slider caption here so it does something when we come in. This time we're going to use a bit of pre-written script or pre-written code that's going to make it really easy for us, and you can get some great results. So I'm going to go to a site called animate.css. I'll put this link below the video here. And this is a whole load of pre-written CSS that you can just insert into your site, and I'll show you how to do that in a moment. But they've got so many different effects that you can put in there. Just select one if you want to check out what it's going to look like, hit animate it, and it'll show you what it's going to do. There you go, it does it straight away. And there's some wonderful effects here. And to actually use this on your site, they've made it so easy for you. You can download it if you want to by hitting this download animate button. And what happens when you hit that is it'll just give you this CSS code. And you can pull this in. Well, let's do it. Select all, control A, control C to copy. We open our brackets text editor here. This brackets is a free text editor, and you can also download it from a link below this video. Let's create a new file and just paste what I've copied, control V, into there. And as you can see, that's just white text because we haven't told brackets what it actually is at the moment. And just save it as whatever you want to call it. Just put .css on the back. It'll let it know it's a cascading style sheet. And hit save. And there we are. You can see it's colored it as proper CSS now for us to edit. And of course, if you want to use this way, you'd have to go back to your Bootstrap index.php and add a link to that style sheet. I'm not going to use this way. I'm going to show you an even easier way to use it. You just put link relative style sheet and a link to the folder or wherever that style sheet you just saved is right there. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to show you an easier way. So if we go back to the Animate CSS site, hit this other button here, View on GitHub. This will take us to their GitHub page. And if we scroll down, it gives you all kinds of instructions. Have a look around here, but I'll show you briefly how to do this. It's very easy. Now, instead of saving that style sheet like we just did and pulling it in, you can have it from a CDN, which is a content delivery network, which means it's just pulling it in from a site on the web. So you don't have to do all that. And to do that, let's go down to this one. I'm going to use the Cloudflare one. You can use that one if you want. And I'm going to copy from the link, the opening tag there, to the closing tag just after CSS here. Control C, back to our index.html. Here we are. And for those of you that haven't been following along with previous videos, here's our folder that we've got all our site files in, little folder with our images in it. Here's our index.html that we've created. Just right click and open it with the brackets and this is what you get. So I'm going to drop down a couple here from the Bootstrap Core CSS and paste in what we just copied from their GitHub site there. I'm just going to tidy that up a bit. And let's give it a title. I'm just going to copy this title and edit it. And just call it Animate. There we go. Now let's save that. Okay, so we put that in there, and that means we're going to pull in those CSS styles. So how do we make them work? Let's look back at their site here. And if we look down here, it says add the class of animated to the element you want to animate. If you want it to just keep animating, you add infinite also. And then just choose the style that you want to do. And they've even included an example here. Now you can put this on text classes, you can put it on divs, you can put it on anything you want. And again, they've got a little button. If you've gone off the page there, you can hit this button, or link, I should say. And it'll take you back to that page where you can choose whatever it is you want. And do have a look through, because they do have some marvelous animations going on. So let's go back and let's actually add some of these to our site. Now here's our site at the moment. And this is what I want to work on today. Here's our index.html page. And that was our carousel captions, which is here, here, and here, because we've got three slides. So let's use the zoom in one. Well, I mean, you can use any one you want. So we've got zoom in left, zoom in right. I'll use a couple of these just for examples. Very easy. But just notice that the I's capitalized, the D's capitalized, L, R, U, and you need to put that in correctly. So it said add the class of animate or animated. And let's use that zoom in capital I. Okay, let's save that and see if it's done what we wanted it to do. Control S to save. This is our first slide caption here. You can put different ones on each of these if you want to, but I'm just using it on the whole block here, which is the heading, the paragraph, and the button. So we've saved that. Let's go back to our site. Refresh, and that should now do that little zoom in animation. There we go. There. Very easy to do. Let's apply it to this element now. Let's do the other slide. Let's do the other slides as well. I'm just literally copying this and pasting it. I'll do different animations on these. I'm going to zoom in right and zoom in left. Like I say, experiment, play with these, do make it your own, and you can get some really cool effects going on. Control S to save. Let's go back to the site and refresh. There's our first one. The second slide should animate to the left, I think it was. And third one to the right. There we go. A little over the top there, but you can do whatever you want with that. So let's apply something to this one here. Back to our HTML. Very easy, like I say. I'm going to copy this over a couple of times. Let's give it a bit of margin top and bottom. New Bootstrap 4 class, you can just write MT for margin top. And it goes from 1 to 5, 5 being the most and 1 being the least. And MB for bottom. And if it's not enough for you, you'll have to add regular CSS. And let's copy this a few times. Control S to save, back to the site. What have we got here? There we go, we've now got something to work with down here that scrolls down the page. Okay, let's add some different ones to this one. Yeah, that'll do. Rotate in, down, left. Yeah, why not? We'll use that one. Okay, back to our site. And again, I'll just copy that class. Animated. Now we want to make sure we get this right or it will not work. I'm going to put it on the whole div again. Like I say, you can put it on the H1 or the P or whatever you want to. Well, let's do that. Let's put it on the heading title this time. Class equals, open and close some inverted commas here. Let's paste in our little code there. And I can't remember what that was said. Rotate in right, wasn't it? Rotate in down left. Capital D, capital L. Capital I. Rotate in, down. Left, and I don't want that gap there. Okay, and we'll copy that and we'll do on the paragraph text. Let's have that going the other way, perhaps. It's got a class in there already, so let's just copy that bit. Paste it after the class that's in there already. It's fine to have multiple classes, and we'll say right for this one. And capital R there, I'm sure. Save that and see what we've got. And refresh. There you go, you can see those two rotating in. Like that. And obviously you can copy your classes down if you want to. I'm just gonna put this on every other div, I think. Sure, I've got a gap there. Let's put this one. On these other divs here. And refresh. There you have it. You've got your animations all over the place. Like I say, play with it, get something that suits you. You might want to keep the same style throughout, but that's entirely up to you. You can change the duration and stuff like that on there. Just read through their descriptions on the GitHub page here. There's all kind of different stuff you can do with it. And it, like I say, it's really easy to use. In our next video, I think what I'd like to see with this is, if I refresh the page, everything's working great. But what I'd like to actually see happen, I'd like to see these actually animate when they come into view. And again, that's pretty easy to do, and we're going to use another bit of pre-written code. So I hope you found this useful. If you have, please like, share, and subscribe the video. If you're interested in web development, take a look below. We've got some great free web development classes. There's also some great premium classes there with huge discounts for our YouTube subscribers. So once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.